Okay, so to work on your web analysis, we need to start your application server, Apache server. After starting this, start your RMI registry. After starting this, start your web analysis services. You'll be having a single web analysis service. Start this particular service. After starting this particular web analysis service, you need to start your workspace services. So for FR and web analysis, compulsorily your workspace services should be started. I'm going to start this particular workspace service. So after starting this particular services, wait for some time. So go into your programs, Oracle EPM systems, and then log into your workspace URL. Mostly it will take like 5-10 minutes to start. Mostly 2 minutes it will take. So log into this. Slower than this. The version right now we are using is 11.12, but in 11.12 if you start all the services and if you start working, like take 15-20 minutes to open each and every page. So now, so if I want to open my web analysis links, so in this you will be having something called as links in tools. You can go into web analysis studio and click on this. When I click on this, will start opening my web analysis studio. Don't close or refresh. And say install. Don't refresh or don't close this particular window. They have given you instructions also. Is installing your J2SE runtime environment. Now it has opened your web analysis. So this is how your web analysis will look like. Okay, so initially if you log in, normally it will, because we are directly logging in from, let me add it to favorites. So let me close this. So let me also close this. Okay. So now let me open my web analysis directly from here. So it will take some time. Don't click any other hyperlink or any other things. So meanwhile, let it open. So initially it will ask for your login credentials. So now it will ask for your login. Admin is with your login credential, username and password will be your password. So if I say login, it will log you into your Sbase, into your web analysis. This is how I have logged into my web analysis application. Now, if I want to create any web analysis report, so go into File, say New. Instead of creating your new report, first you have to create your database connection. So with which all things you can create your database connection, and you can create with your analytics service. Analytics is nothing but your Sbase. Sbase is also called as analytical server. Till your 6, 7 version or even 9.3 version we used to call it as Hyperion Sbase Analytical Server, and another one we used to call it as Hyperion Sbase Administration Server. EAS, EAAS. A is nothing but Analytical Administration Server. Okay, same as this is nothing but your Sbase server. And financial management, HFM you can connect, SAP BW you can connect, SAS, you can also connect to your relational database. But here you can connect only to your analytical service. Let me say analytical service. So database server name you have to provide. Host is your server name. Admin is your username and password is your password. If you want, you can save this user ID and you can save it. I'll say next. When I say next, it will log into your Sbase server and it will pull all the information from there. So ours is Apple and you want to connect to your EMP database. Apple EMP. I'll say next. So how you want to format all this numeric formatting, numeric how many precisions you want, and apart from that, so if the particular cell is having mostly if you are having hash missing, how it will be displaying? It will be displaying in the text format as not applicable. You don't have any data. Or if I want to get it displayed with zeros, I can make it as zero, or I can make it as also just like your Excel sheet, right? Okay. And I'll say next. So whenever you want to do some drill through reports, whenever you want to connect to a relational database, then you'll be using this particular thing. But we are not connecting to a relational database, we are connecting to a Sbase database. We are not going to touch this activity. Let me say finish. With this, my database connection has been created with Apple and EMP, but I have to give a name to it. Where it is getting stored? In users, admin and database folder is getting created with a name called as Basel. Okay. So where it is getting created? User, admin, and in this you are able to see your databases. Whenever I click, this is getting created into this. Okay, now I want to create a web analysis report. For that I'll say file. Database connection is done. Okay, so and apart from this, if you see there are three different modes. This is something called as designer mode, this is nothing but analyzer mode, and this is nothing but your desktop. So most of the times we have to switch into your designer mode, where you can design your web analysis reports. After creating your database connection, now switch to your designer mode, where you can design your web analysis report. So if you see, you can create a chart or you can create a spreadsheet report. Let us create a spreadsheet report. So when I click on this and if I drag this onto this, it will display a sheet. So what you want to connect? Add a data source to this particular activity for a spreadsheet type of activity. Let me say OK. Which is that? This is the database connection. If I say OK, it will automatically display my Apple related information, Apple EMP related information. So in this, say from accounts, I want my accounts into my columns. So which all accounts you want? Say I want revenues, expenses, and let me right click on this and I say select children. Also select descendants. So this way we can select them. Either you can directly select descendants of revenues or you can also select expense 1, 2, and 3. And I'll say OK. So now I have my accounts in columns. Now into my rows, I want my entities. So automatically it gets selected. So I want say KPHP, Secunderabad, Vishakhapatnam, Vizag. I have my entities in place. In pages, if you want, you can pull here years. So what all you want in here? Say F11, 10, and 9 into my years. Okay. Remaining dimensions, I am not that much interested. Or I also want my periods into my columns. Let's. So in periods, let me take only January, February, and March. Okay. Remaining scenario related information I don't want, because the name of the form will be actual form, so I don't want any scenario to be requested. So what I'll do is I'll click on this scenario, and from this scenario I'll be selecting actions. But if I open this particular web form after saving, what it will do is your suppress and missing will be selected. So for that I'll go into options, and in this if you see there is an option called as suppress. In this, it is suppressing your hash missing values and your shared members. So what I'll do is I'll suppress and remove this suppression, and I also remove this shared suppression. Now if I say OK, this particular web form has been designed earlier. This is how your web form, web analysis web form will be displayed. Now I cannot change anything in this. If I want to change it, I have to switch to analyzer mode. Here I can change things. So here if I want, I can change my year FI10. Now it is changing to FI10. Same way, I want to change to FI0. I can change to FI0. And now if I want to input any data into this particular cells, let me say to FI11. If I want to input anything into this particular FI11, I'll go into this cell, right click on this, go into analysis tool, or edit data, sorry. Select this edit data. You'll be getting a toolbar below this. You have something called as a refresh button, calculate button, and you can also submit your data. Now if I want to input anything into this cell, double click in this, clear of this not applicable, make it undone. So after inputting this, let me press an enter and then say submit your data. When I say submit, changes have been applied. This particular data is logged and sent into your SPS. From here, you can log and send it. From your web application, you can log and send this data. And if you want to calculate, perform any calculations, you can run your calculations. Right now you are having only default calculation. If I say OK, this starts calculating your data. So this is how you can do your calculation further from your web analysis. Now apart from this, what all I can do? Come back to designer mode. So I want to do some conditional formatting. If it is less than 100, this particular 200, if this particular value is less than 100, it has to display in red ink. If it is in between 100 and 200, it has to display in yellow color. If it is above 200 it has to display in green color. I want this type of conditional formatting in my web analysis. How I can do it? I can do it in my analyzer mode. Right click on your KBHP, and if you go into your analysis tools, there is a topic called as traffic lights. If you select this traffic lights, now you can fix your values. If it is between 100 and 200, if it is above 200, it has to display in green color. If it is between 200 and 100, and 100, it has to display in yellow color, and if it is below your 100, it has to display in red color. Okay, so I'll say apply and I'll say okay. So for this entire column, this particular activity will be applied. So this is how I can apply conditional formatting in this. Apart from this, I don't know for which this particular web form is getting opened. Say right now it is opening for actual. Now I want to open this for budget. Intermediately, now I want to open it for my budget. But user says I want to open it for actuals. I also want to open it for budget. Based upon my requirement, I should get a selection. If I select actuals, it has to open for actuals. If I select budget, it has to open for budget. Like just like your page. So now I'll go back to my designer mode. In this designer mode, I can select a wide variety of activities. Either I can select a sliding subscription, or I can select a multi-level combo box, or I can select radio buttons, or I can select combo box subscription. Whenever I click, it will drag down, and in that you can select your options. So let me go with my radio buttons. So when I select this radio buttons, and if I drag it here, it is selecting report. I want to select the same data source for this, and what dimension you want in it. I want scenario dimension within it. I'll say okay. And in this, what all members you want. So I'll say add. I want actuals, budgets, forecast, variance. I'll say okay. And apart from that, they should pull values dynamically. Where can I set this? Okay, let us see this. I'll say okay. Now if you see this particular radio combo box has come here. Now I want this to be somewhere here. Now let me switch back to my analyzer mode. Now if you see, I am able to see my actual, budget, forecast and variance. See, if I select actuals, it is already selected to your actuals. Now if I select my budget, it is opening my budget related values. If I select forecast, it is opening my forecast related values. If I select my variance, it is going to open my variance related values. This way I can design thing. What is this? It is nothing but you are designing your web page. Almost you are designing a web page. You can design your combo box. You can have even your slider for different things, say for periods. If you remove these periods, you can have a slider. Now I also want a text in this. So to insert your text, what I can do is I can say, where is this option I can select. So when I select this and if I drag it here, so wherever you want, you can tag it. And whatever font you want, you can select that. Say Vardhaman, you can have Toma, you can have all varieties of encryptions. Let me say Toma, and I want it to be say 20. And the color should be something like this. And I also want it to be in bold. So now I can type my text. This is my report. I am able to see this. So wherever I want, I can place it in a comfortable position. You can insert an image into this. You can pull the company logo into this. Switch to your analyzer mode. Now you are able to see. You can change your entire background, whatever you want it to be. Okay, let me save this. I'm going to save it in user admin reports with a name called as bar. So this particular web analysis report is now saved. Now if I want to open it, let me open it in my workspace. So in this, if you want to open your web analysis reports or financial reports, you have to select your Explorer, and in this, where is it? It is in users, admin, reports, and you are able to see your bar web analysis report. Let me double click on this. So it is going to open my web analysis report in this. And in this web analysis report, if you are an administrator, you can do many things out of this. You can put your traffic lights, analysis tools you can set. You can do retrieve only top button. You can restrict data. You can sort. You can even do a formatting of this particular cell. What type of formatting you want, you can do all this formatting. If you want your KPHB only, it has to be displayed in bold. Font color you can set only for this particular entity. And data format also you can set, everything you can do with this. Prefix your decimals and all these types of activities you can do. For KPHB, you can have a different type of thing for Secunderabad, Visakhapatnam. And finally, everything is web-based report that you want to do. Okay? These types of things you can be doing in this. And you can also do a zoom in and zoom out in this. Say, if I want to zoom out. Analysis drill. I want to zoom up. If I say it will come out of second column. If I want to zoom in, right click on this, in this drill, drill, down. So I can drill down. If you take your financial reports, in financial report I cannot edit my numbers, so let me set it to actuals. So now if I want to set submit my data, what I'll be doing, I'll be right click on this and I'll say data, edit your data. So now I can edit my data into this. So let me make it as 200 or 2000, okay. And then say send it. Updated successfully. If I want to run any calculations, I can run my calculations from here only. So everything in a web form itself I can do. Okay. After doing this, I will say exit. Now I will be able to see that information. Okay. So, but in your financial reports cannot be drilled down. They are static. They cannot change. And apart from that, you cannot change your data in your in your web analysis you can change, but in your financial reports you cannot change. Why do we need these many types of reporting systems? Your Excel admin or web analysis or smart view, these are used only for internal reporting purpose. In a company, if you want to publish your data into a company to say what your incomes are to your higher authorities, for that purpose you will be using web analysis reports or Excel admin reports, or you will be using smart view related. But when you want to display your results to external world, you will be using financial reports, because no one is going to change your data. should not change your data. In that situation, we will be using financial reports. External auditing purpose, we will be using financial reports. Internal auditing purpose, we will be using web analysis. So where this particular security is managed? Security is managed in your workspace only. So if I want to provide security on this particular reports, so right click on this and you have something called as edit permissions. So when you say edit permissions, you will be having all users available, because whoever user is available on this particular group will have access, and after that you can provision them. What type of access you have to provide, you can make them as a default permission for all files import, push these items to select user groups and roles. So you can have different types of roles in this. In the same way, you can take an export of this, and you can also have an import of this particular activity. You can have a HTML, or you can have a web analysis related studio. You can open it in a URL also. So all these things you can do in your properties. What properties will you be having? So permissions, from here you can set who all should have access on this. Right now admin can have access on this. If you provision users in this, in web analysis studio, you can also provide access to those users. And apart from that, versions, this is the only one version. Some advanced things, hide files. If you want to hide this particular thing, you can hide it, so no users can see all these things. So date related information, keywords, all these things you can see. So this is about your web analysis. Simple. You can create a web analysis report in your web analysis studio. If you want to create a new thing, I'll send you in designer mode. Let me say file new. Close this. So now if I want a new thing, go to analyzer mode, right. You can create a new web analysis. Always come to analyzer mode, close those, open a new web analysis. Here we should be getting material now due to display settings. So this way you can have different types of things. You can pull an image into this. You can have an image into this, whatever you want to have, you can get into this, like images. Apart from that, you can put text, you can have a pin chart type of activity. So this is the database connection that I am going to use. So let me say accounts, I want all my revenue accounts. Into this, into columns. To rows, let me say periods, okay, let me say this will create your chart based upon the data that you have had. This will create your chart. So you can have a chart, you can also have a pin board. So period. So if it is less than 100. This will create my so everything is getting displayed in the same color. If you want, you can change the color. revenues analyzer. Pin, even you can change your pin size. Pin color will also be changed. And approximately your pins will also move up and down. So these kind of activities you can do in your web analysis. Far much better than your financial reports. And in financial reports you will be having column formatting alone. You will not have all such activities in your web analysis. Column row you can have a formula, you can have many things. That type of activities are not possible in your web analysis. So with this we have completed web analysis. Very simple thing. Mostly security, where you can do it, from web analysis you can do it. From your workspace you can do your security provisioning and all. You cannot do it from here. You have to provision it from your workspace only. And apart from that, you have designer mode, analyzer mode, and you have analyzer, designer mode and desktop. Desktop, you know how it has to be, no presentation on the desktop. How for an end user it has to be displayed. That you can set on your desktop. So these many things are there. Save as, save, hide view pan, this particular pan will be added. And these things are nothing but you can have multiple options. You can check each and everything. We have seen only radio buttons. We didn't see the slider also. And we didn't see selection button subscriptions. There are many things. Alias controller, how to set your aliases. Whether you want default alias, India alias, UK alias, all these things. And services, many things are there. Mostly these options are. You can check all these options. SQL spreadsheet, whenever you are using a SQL database, you will be using this. Mostly with your SQL database, you can use this. We will be using only these options. Right? So, with this, we are done with your web analysis. Very simple. You need to start web analysis report. So services that you need to start is, you need to start first your Apache, RMI, then your web analysis, and after that start your workspace. For financial reports, what all you will be starting? Apache, RMI, after that you will be running your financial report, print server, report server, scheduler, and finally your web application. After that you will be starting your workspace agent and then your workspace web application. Start the financial. Okay. So we'll stop for today. This completes here.